Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in the series on Django fundamentals. So today we're going to configure icons and attach them with our Django messages. So let's get straight to it. Okay, so let's just evaluate what we did last time. So last time, okay, we went to our view on register and we sent a Django notification message or Django message here to say, okay, the message was successful. Okay, the user was created, and we can say here, we said here in the message, the user was registered successfully. Okay, and then what we did next was we went ahead to our login page, and this was because we were being redirected to our login page. So here we would see that user notification or event. Now all that was output here was our message, which was contained here in the second parameter as some text. And we of course went through a for loop, output all our messages, and we output it here. Okay, so that's all that happened. Now let's see this practically to understand. So let's go to register, and let's register a user. So here I'm just going to say test1@gmail.com. So just enter some dummy data for now. Register your user, and there we have it. The user was registered successfully. Now this looks a little bit dull. We want to go ahead and add actually an icon to it, okay? And we can also later on go ahead and add icons to our buttons as well. Okay, so first of all, we will need the Font Awesome CDN. Now, Font Awesome is a place where we can use icons and add icons to our projects. So the first thing I want us to do is actually get that CDN. So you can type in Google here, Font Awesome W3 Schools. And there is a guide here that will give you a brief understanding to it. I'll just go through it with you briefly. Now, we need the CDN first before we can utilize icons like this car here, for example. So we can just copy the CDN, and we need to add this to the HTML template where we will be utilizing these icons. So in this case, it's going to be in my login here, and I'm just going to copy the CDN. This will allow us to use icons from Font Awesome. Okay, next we can actually go ahead and render an icon. So I'm going to, for example, render this car icon, so you get the idea. So this is an example of it. Actually, all of these are icons, are these icons here. So you can see here, this one is plain, this one has a bigger font size, this one has a bigger font size and is red. Okay, so let's copy the normal one, and I'm going to put it just here under the login title, just so you can see it. Now if we were to go back to, we can refresh this page actually, and we can now see we have an icon here, a Font Awesome icon of a car. Now what we're going to do, first of all, is add an icon to our user notification message, and then we're going to go ahead and add this to a button, so everything looks a bit nicer. So let's for now delete this, and what we need to do is we need to go ahead and add that message here in front of our message, in front of our message. So let's go to Font Awesome. So we're going to use Font Awesome 4.7, so it's a bit older, but it's much easier to use, and we can go to Font Awesome Icons. And here we go, we can see there are a bunch of icons that we can use, okay? So I'm going to search for just tick, okay? And this one is perfectly fine. So this is a check mark, and here's the icon. You can just copy that, put it in front of your Django message, and add a non-breaking space here, so at NBSP, okay? This ensures there's a space between your icon and your message, so it doesn't look cluttered. Now let's test this again. And let's refresh first of all and register a user. So here I'm going to say test2@gmail.com. And we want to see if we have an icon that gets appended to our notification. So let's see. And there we go. So we can see we have a nice check mark there that says the user was registered successfully. Okay. So that's how we can utilize Django messages with Font Awesome. Okay, so what I want us to do now as kind of a bonus is to go ahead and actually add icons to our buttons. Okay, so as we can, let's go back to our code. And as we can see here, we have an input here for our input button and the value here. Now we can't go ahead and add this because if you look what will happen here, if we add that there, it's just going to look like an absolute mess. Okay, so this is not going to work. We can only add text in this value property here. So let's go back and what we need is a bit of leeway here. We want to be able to freely edit this text. So what we can utilize is a button instead. Okay. Now I want us to go ahead and just create a simple button. So we can just say button, and the class is going to inherit the bootstrap properties. So just here, this is sufficient. And the type, we need to say submit or else this won't send our actual data. Now we can just open and close this, and I'm just going to put an example here called test. Now let's go back and refresh, and there we go. Perfect. Now this button is usable. And the good thing is now we have freedom now. We're not limited to only adding text. We can go ahead and actually add an icon now. Now, since we are logging in, we would need an appropriate icon. So let's go back to Font Awesome and look for something appropriate. So I always like to use key. So key as in reference to like login sort of. So I'll copy this icon, put it in front here now. And this is the good thing. We can now override this and add anything that we want. Add a non-breaking space. And we can go ahead and comment this out. Just like that. Let's refresh. And there we go. Oh, the text is a bit wrong, so let's just add that. So here I'm just going to say login. Okay, let's go back. There we go. Now let's actually test this with a valid user and see if it works. There we go. So it works perfectly. Okay, so this is how you can also go further and add icons to your buttons. All right, so that's that.